Diamond Nationals, amen. Diamond Nationals, Sunday night, amen. Chris Ferguson on the pole.
Thank you. Mile Speedway for the General Tire Diamond Nationals, presented by Super Clean. Chris Ferguson still in total control of this race.
Come on.
unfortunately, and here you see the number one, Chad Simpson. So we didn't get a lap in. Go back to lap 29. We'll stop him here. Still under caution, but we've got to clear the back straightaway. Kyle Bronson involved in that one, seventh in the point standings. A little damage to the right side of his race car, most notable around the right rear tire. Chad Simpson's car is destroyed on the front end. He tried to stay off Jonathan Davenport, not get into him too hard, but he and Jonathan Davenport were racing for the same real estate, and when he did, he got hit. Here's the damage to Kyle Bronson's car. You see the sheet metal bent up around that right rear tire. Fortunately, it looks like it's bent away from the right rear.
Yeah, great camera shot there. There's Billy Moyer Jr. back there right now. Runs in fifth. So 21 to go. Ferguson, Owens, Buckingham, and Clint Moyer Jr., your top five. Then it's farther down the court. And I believe Stovall, he continued on. Denny seems to be out. Decker will be up to spot, and they will be out.
Billy Moyer Jr. has his helmet off. Let's go to Dave.
Discussion here. The officials are going to allow the cars to pull around here and allow the helmets to be replaced. Crew members are asked to get a helmet ready with a bunch of tear offs because just about everybody has used up everything in terms of visibility with this heavy racetrack. So you see a flurry of activity as the cars pull around here and the cars stop and the drivers replace their muddy helmets with a clean.
And that explains why Billy Moyer Jr. has his helmet. We saw him putting tear-offs on that helmet just prior to the feature of this heavy racetrack and all that mud. Take a look at it on the front end of the 21. Several drivers, I'm sure, wanting to get that cleaned off or just replace their helmet for better visibility.
Yeah, great call by the series officials for safety purposes, obviously. And we won't see my hit or anything like that.
But here's the interesting thing, the impact of the helmets. Do they have the tear-offs prepared? You can see right there, I believe that was Tim McCready's helmet.
That's Andrea.
Yep. There's Andrea. That is Josh Richards' wife. She kept it prepared.
She's got her own safety helmet.
She does.
Yeah.
The mud shield.
The mud shield, yes.
She's got a backup helmet for Josh Richards.
Thank you.
Jimmy Owens has a right front tire going down. They spotted it when they came out to change the helmet. Just a tough break for your point leader. He is headed for the work area.
Bad break for point leader Jimmy Owens. The last couple of races, it's been that way for him. He had trouble at Florence, hit the wall while leading at Florence Speedway in the Summer Sizzler. Then on Friday night at Tri-City Speedway, he and Shane Clanton made contact. He had charged from 15th to 5th and wound up 15th in that race. And then running here, second tonight in the Diamond Nationals, going after his 5th win in this race, has a tire going down, and now he's in the hot pit area.
And then if he comes back out, which he will, there are 20 cars still in the race, so he will restart in 20th. So that'll move Buckingham up to second, Clan to third, and Lear Jr. to fourth, Marler to fifth.
Right front tire is the issue on the 20 of Jimmy Owens. Taking a look at Kyle Bronson and seeing what's going on with that 40B as well. Many of these drivers changed their helmets. I don't believe Chris Ferguson actually did. There is the apparent right front tire on Jimmy Owens' machine. They're taking a look at it right now. But Jimmy Owens running second with an issue to the hot pit area to change that right front tire.
I'm trying to figure out where the cut was or what they ran it over.
He's pressing the tire. You can tell it is soft indeed. Not exactly sure where the cut was, but it had lost pressure on the right front. And now Jimmy Owens to the tail of the field. Billy Moyer Jr. now to the hot pit area. So two of the top five runners in this race with 21 laps to go to the hot pit area. Straightening out the spoiler and the right rear quarter panel on that 21.
From Shane Clan's team down there as well, helping out their fellow Capital driver, Billy Moyer Jr., give up his 5th spot. Owens gives up 2nd to be on the tail end. So out of the race right now, Peyton Looney was the first one out, then Jeremiah Hurst, Earl Pearson Jr. is out, Mason Oberkramer, Billy Moyer, Ricky Thornton Jr., and Cody Laney all out of the race. 20 cars remain. Here comes BMJ back.
Just got word from Dave Argerbright that the right rear tire on Billy Moyer Jr.'s car had to be changed. side. Let's go. Bring the drivers near the hot pit area.
17 to go here tonight.
Second and
Owens and Kyle Stricker. But bad luck again for point leader Jimmy Owens tonight here at Lucas Oil Speedway. Right now, 15 cars still running. Owens comes back down. There will be OB in 15. All of the lead laps was progressing down.
Races for that rookie.
check this out. The race to the finish. Nobody thought Jonathan Davenport had a chance. What a run off of turn number four. By just that much, Chris Ferguson wins the Diamond Nationals at the Diamond of Dirt Tracks.
Instead, he got sent to the back twice.
He earned it and deserved it, just like Nick Liddy did last time. Only a second time he's ever raced here. The first time was last night. This is going to be great. Look at how spooked Chris Ferguson is in the cockpit of that race car. Pure emotion, pure joy tonight for the driver out of Mount Holly, North Carolina. 15 different winners of the Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series. There's I'm out of breath. That was well worth the wait here. About one quarter after midnight here on the old man here in Wayland. This series just produces some fantastic finishes, especially